I've learned that I spend way too much money on food. Now, there's four of us in the house, but over $1,238 on food. I can't really say where it all went because that's additional to the Optiva that I buy for myself, which is my diet program. So if I look at food all encompassing, that's almost $2,000 in food. That's crazy. And if I just look at the family outside of that, or the additional food that I buy on top of Optiva, that is $1,238. Ahead and made a list of everything that came out of that account when it comes to food. A lot of it is restaurants or going somewhere with the kids or being in the mall and ordering a pretzel. And all these little charges, they add up. They add up to over $1,200 in food costs for the month of December. Now, granted, it's the holidays. I probably did buy a little more things than I normally would buy, but still, over $1,200 in food for four people, not including my meals that come from Optiva, otherwise it'd be close to 2,000, is excessive. And that's because we put no limits on it. We just say we want this for dinner and we do that, or we're out somewhere and we get dinner for four. And that is racking up every single month. The next area that I spend a lot on is that Amazon stuff category. And granted, it was the holidays, so some things were purchased that way, but I tried to eliminate those when looking at how much it was actually spent. And it was still over $630 on stuff. Now, it could be, paper products that I purchased through it, or a tool that we needed to fix something, or, little gadgets that I know that would be helpful that we needed, or something broke and there was a part missing, or someone lost the charger to something, so I ordered the charger for it. But still, that all encompassing adds up over time, and you don't realize it because you just put it in the cart and then buy it. It's $20, it's $10, it's $5, it's $7. But for the accumulation of the month, those things equaled over $630. And the other category was beauty. Going into Sephora and buying, the latest makeup or a new eyeshadow palette, or getting my nails done, or getting a pedicure done. And so all of that, getting it done was about over $576 in just beauty care. And a lot of that I know I can save on. It's more of a convenience, having someone do my nails or having someone go do my toes or getting my eyebrows done. And so this month moving forward, I'm definitely going to look into ways that I can save money and still utilize all the things that I love about taking care of yourself. So for example, instead of getting my nails done, I normally get them dipped, which can cost me like $50 every 2, 3 weeks when I get them dipped. So I'm eliminating that. I cut my nails down short and I started to purchase the nail decals. They're kind of like stickers that you put on your nails to show the nail polish on them. And that way it wouldn't be damaging to my nails. And then it would also look like my nails were done, right? That cost me $7 versus the cost of $50 and will last equally as long and better for my nails. And so I'll talk about some of those little things I do to save money in another video, but that's definitely one of them. I'm going to plan out activities for the family that require no money. It would be like a scheduled event, like this is the day that we're going to the park all day and have a picnic. This is the day that we're going to go on a long bike ride. This is the day that we're going to go walk around this new area, and we're not going to bring our funding with us. We're just going to window shop and see. And I'm going to plan out at least twice a month some of those activities that cost no money for the family. And that will also eliminate extra costs like food costs, because we can bring things with it, activity costs, stuff costs, because we're planning out things that we can do as a family that doesn't cost us anything. Start to track. Moving forward, I probably can do it once a week, but in this beginning phase of now starting this, I'm probably gonna every few days whip out the budget and see what I've spent so far, and so I can continue to stay on track. If I find that certain areas I've already went over, and there's nothing I can do when I have to go over, I'm gonna fix that by lowering the cost in other areas. So maybe I do no beauty products this month, or maybe I do no Amazon shopping this month if I happen to go over in the food cost already, because that's a big change from $1,200 down to $630, right? So these are the five things that I'm going to try differently this month, to see if I can actually stay on that budget. All right. Good luck to all of you who are also working on your budget for 2022, seeing ways that you can save money, because we all don't want to work forever. Right? All right. Thanks, guys. Until next time. Bye.
Receipts be looking like phone numbers. If it ain't money, then wrong number. Black card is my business card away.